Speak Student!
Proving triangles congruent, a la Shmoop. Dr. Feleinstein's experiment to breed a race of talking house cats with heightened awareness of democratic treatment and equality has gone terribly awry. The cats quickly split into two opposing parties. Each thought their respective philosophy would most benefit the group as a whole. To control them, the doctor roped off two triangular areas in corners of the rectangular room that housed the cats, so the parties could not, attack each other. This quickly backfired as both parties began to demand that their sections of quarantine be exactly the same area and shape. But how is the doctor going to prove that their areas are congruent without having to reach into two pits of murderous, politically conscious cats? Well, the hypotenuse leg theorem, abbreviated HL, states, two right triangles are congruent if their hypotenuses are congruent and a corresponding leg is congruent. Perhaps Dr. Feleinstein can use this to prove the cat's space is congruent. We've established that the room is a rectangle. Everyone agrees on that. That means each triangle has one right angle, making them both right triangles. We also know that because the room is a rectangle, these sides opposite each other are the same length. Dr. Feleinstein knows he used the same length of rope to contain the two cat parties. In this case, the rope represents the hypotenuse of those triangles because it's the side opposite the right angle. So these two right triangles have the same length of hypotenuse as well as corresponding legs of the same length. By the hypotenuse leg theorem, the triangles are congruent. It's important to note that the hypotenuse leg theorem is the only case of the side-side angle that one can use to prove that two triangles are congruent. At least the cats can stop arguing about that for now. Next topic, the tuna deficit.